I'm Saki, and I'm happy to be here with you today. Welcome to Season 2 of our IoT and ESP32 series. As IoT technology continues to evolve rapidly, advanced communication protocols and ML capabilities are gaining importance. ESP32C6 and ESP32C3 chips are leading the pack. The ESP32C6 with its robust wireless capabilities boosts IoT device performance. Meanwhile, the ESP32C3's machine learning prowess opens up new possibilities for developers. Today, we'll explore the unique features and benefits of these chips and highlight their innovative use in real-world IoT projects. Our goal with this episode is to spark new ideas and inspire your own IoT projects. The ESP32C6 is a high-performance chip featuring a 32-bit RISC-V process. Built on the RISC-V architecture, it offers robust processing power and a versatile instruction set, ideal for complex IoT applications. Notably, RISC-V cost-effectiveness is another key advantage. In terms of wireless protocols, the ESP32C6 supports Wi-Fi 6 at 2.4 GHz. With backward compatibility for 802.1bg and N8 features uplink, downlink authentication, and multi-rate access, as well as downlink MU-MIMO technology. These features ensure performance even in crowded networks with efficient, low-latency operation. ESP32C6 integrates IEEE 802.15.4 Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 5, supporting Thread and Zigbee protocols. It's suitable for creating Meta Wi-Fi and Meta Thread devices, enabling seamless interaction among diverse smart home ecosystems. By pairing the ESP32C6 with other ESP32C6, it's also capable of creating various IoT solutions, including Thread Border Router, Smart Gateways, and Zigbee Bridges. With its robust wireless capabilities, the ESP32C6 enables smart home devices with seamless connectivity and interoperability. In a smart home setup, an ESP32C6-based gateway smart lighting systems allow remote control via Zigbee for adjusting power and brightness. Smart locks operate via Bluetooth for access. Environmental sensors can monitor indoor air quality in real time, uploading data to the cloud via Wi-Fi for analysis and visualization. Let's discuss the ESP32S3. It features a dual core architecture using the Xtensor 32-bit RX7 processor. The processor clocks at 240 MHz, offering more processing power than the 160 MHz ESP32C6. Ideal for complex parallel processing tasks, offering smooth GUI and user interaction. Additionally, ESP32 offers human-machine interface solutions, perfect for smart devices, home automation panels, and IoT dashboards. ESP32S3's MCU includes vector instructions to boost AS and signal processing. Developers can access these via ESP, DSP, and ESP double-in libraries, enabling high-performance image recognition and voice activation features. Like other ESP32 chips, the S3 variant supports UART, SPI, I2C, ADC, DAC, and other interfaces, while also featuring 45 programmable GPIO pins for connecting various devices and sensors. Thus, ESP32C3 is ideal for service robotics applications. Leveraging its powerful computing and neural network acceleration, the ESP32 enables real-time image processing and recognition, allowing robots to perform object detection, navigation, and facial recognition. Additionally, its voice recognition capabilities powered by the ESP-DSP library enable high-performance voice activation and command recognition, enhancing robot user interactions. Furthermore, the ESP32-S3 offers multi-sensor support and 45 programmable I/O pins, allowing for integration of more sensors and enabling smarter environmental awareness and decision-making. DF Robot's Fire Beetle development board retains user-friendly interface and charging features while being tailored to leverage the ESP32 chip's capabilities. For instance, the ESP32-S3 version, it includes camera and display interfaces, making AR vision projects easier. We've optimized power consumption for the ESP32-C6. Sleep mode consumes only 16 microamperes. It also supports solar charging and more. Now let me introduce a community project. This project utilizes ESP32-C6 to create a Meta protocol-based smart LED light. Now let's set up the programming environment. First, we'll install ESP IDF. ESP IDF is quite large, so it'll take a while. We'll fast forward this part. The tutorial shows it's a quick install. Now let's proceed with the installation. We've skipped ahead a bit here. In this case, the actual Meta installation still takes quite a lot of time. Next, we'll set up the environment. We'll now enter the IDE environment. To check our sample code, first, we'll navigate to the project directory, which contains our project files. Then we'll locate our example code. Next, we'll compile the code. The system indicates a missing component, so let's install it now. Once the installation is complete, we'll need to configure it briefly. So we're working with an ESP32-C6 chip here. The next step is to compile the code. The initial compilation might take a while, but after that, we'll be ready to flash the code onto our ESP32-C6 chip. The flashing process is now complete. Now let's open the serial port. You'll see lots of terminal output in the serial monitor. We'll use the command line interface to interact with the chip. First things first, we need to connect to our Wi-Fi network. Then we'll activate the pairing mode on the device. Once the pairing process is done, we'll be able to establish communication with our ESP32-C6 chip. Next, let's pair the Meta device. Once paired, we'll establish a connection using the Meta protocol. In this terminal window, we enter the pairing command. After pairing, we'll see a confirmation message in the serial terminal. The Meta connection is now established. Now we can use the terminal to input commands and control our switch. By entering the on command, we can see the light turn on. We can also use a command to turn off the light. As you can see, with simple program controls, we can remotely control our smart LED over the network. In the next project, we utilize the ESP32's acceleration feature to enable real-time camera streaming and facial recognition on a web page. In this program, we'll examine how the ESP32S3 handles facial recognition. To start, we need to connect to our Wi-Fi network. We'll input our Wi-Fi name and password into the program. Let's take a quick look at the code here. It's fairly short, so we can review it quickly. Now let's take a look at this part on this web page, which serves as our server interface. You can see the code related to facial recognition, which has been implemented using our library. All right, now we're going to flash the code onto the device. Let's pause here for a moment and take a quick look. Make sure our settings match the red marked options. This ensures we can flash the device correctly. All right, everything looks good after our check. Now we can select our port and proceed with compiling and flashing. The compilation and flashing process for the ESP32 board takes a bit of time. So we'll need to wait a moment. Okay, let's start flashing the code now. Once the flashing is done, let's open the serial monitor. You'll see a URL appear in the monitor. Now let's open that URL. Keep in mind, we need to be on the same network. Now when we open it, we should be able to see the live image feed. Next, let's enable the facial recognition feature. Notice a box appears showing it's working. It's now detecting and framing our face in the image. Warnings are appearing here. Next, it displays the corresponding role. Then it shows relevant prompts. This completes the process. Notice how our avatar turns green and the course and down label appears. In simple terms, the facial recognition is processed locally by the MCU. Now consider this. Wouldn't this be perfect for a smart doorbell? With these demonstrations, we've given you a hands-on look at the ESP32C6 and CES3 real-world performance in IoT devices and the advantages of our DF Robot Fire Beetle board in project development. As AI language models grow popular, ESP32S3 expands possibilities for edge computing. By integrating edge computing apps with large-scale models, we unlock a world of new possibilities. For instance, we can transform regular toys into AI-powered talking smart toys. AI-enhanced smart speakers will become a seamless part of our daily lives. As Meta Thread Networking Protocol evolve, more smart home devices will adopt ESP32C6 as their controller. With competitive pricing and Wi-Fi 6 support, ESP32C6 offers advanced connectivity. ESP32C6 will power various smart devices like automated blind sensors and thermometers. The primary controller for smart home devices like sockets, locks, lights, and gateways. If you're interested in DF Robot's Fire Beetle 2 ESP32 we've discussed, feel free to leave comments and hit the like button. Of course, if you have any questions about the product, don't hesitate to start a discussion in our community forum. That wraps up everything for this video. Thanks for watching. In our next video, we'll showcase some practical projects and guide you through their creation. If that piques your interest, join us for some hands-on tinkering. See you next time.